Word number one.
Word number one, and then we're gonna head all the way to the northern part of the project, number two, and then make our way back. And then if you have time, you can go to six, or you can see six on your way back. And that's the pull-out parking area at the very southern end. And you can get out, look around, and kind of see where the old road alignment was. And we designed all that with contour grading to hide that parking lot, but yet still make it look natural and form, but then not block the view of the lighthouse and the driving.
And so just a reminder, you guys all get that PCH was closer and this was moved inland, and that's what's the start of all this stuff.
So right here is a piece of the old highway. So if you guys want to come over here, this is an old motel. It's not owned by the park. That's BLM land. So they give tours of the lighthouse. Side of those cypress trees where the waves are crashing, that's where the road used to be. It was protected by rock salt protection or
riprap.
And we were told by the Coastal Commission that we couldn't do that any longer because of they don't want to have hardened so we took that out. It's happening all over the world, so not just here. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to get back in your vehicles. You guys just came in too?
Yeah.
We're going to used to run right here and go down along the top line, and we need the alignment. brain.
In the parking lot, in the parking lot.
Yeah, this is a remnant part of the old alignment. Before we start though, I wanted to show you, I'm just going to pass this around. So when you do a design in conceptual design and then bring it into working drawings for a contract, I don't know if any of you guys know about this, but it's called PS&E. So you develop your plans. These are plans. S is specs. These are the specifications. And E, PS and E, estimate. These three things make up a biddable contract. This is what goes out to bid, and this is what the contractor's using to build the project. So everything's in here, and everything has to match all the pay items. All the language is legal. Every word means something, so you've got to get it just right, or they will, contractor will find holes in it and make a lot of money. Here at the northern section is a, where we're going to be building part of the coastal trail for state parks on our property. And if you've never seen working drawings where you have to develop a change order with the contractor, there's a lot of red ink on here. This is how you develop change order drawings. And so this is what I did, and this is what they're going to be surveying on Monday and starting to break ground on Tuesday. So that's just a piece of many pieces of the pie for this project. So if you're interested in looking at that, I have all of these things you can look at later. All these things are connected to natural land colors, and this one here. We didn't do the traditional like 2-to-1 cut, which you see all over in traditional projects. We wanted it to blend with the natural land colors. This is part of the coastal trail. And the coastal trail will eventually go from the Mexican border all the way up to Oregon. So this is a segment of the California coastal trail. And everything looks really dry right now because the rains haven't really started. So, but in the springtime, it's really beautiful. Lots of flowering perennials and annuals. So, come out when it's blooming. whale spouting out here. Really exciting to see. So let's cross here. Can everybody?
For the restoration, for the erosion control, developing the seed mixes for all the different types of vegetative habitats. So this is where the road went off, and we re-sculpted the land to, you couldn't really tell. This is where we're going to be building the trail starting next week. It's going to blend in right here, and it's going to follow along the top of a very large drainage system that collects the water on that east side where all those slopes go into a swale on the east side of the road, because you can see the road kind of vertically sloped that way. This is on a curve. We call that a vertical profile, and it's also a horizontal profile because there's a curve. So the water is going that way. A lot of water's being drained then under the road, outletting down along the end of this fence. And that's why our right-of-way has a jog here, is to allow for that end of that pipe to be on our property. So State Parks is getting an encroachment permit to build this trail, and they're going to maintain it in perpetuity. So we as good neighbors are building it for them to make good relations with another agency. It's always good to...
Are you implying that agencies don't always work well together? Is that what you're implying?
Oftentimes, things happen in relationships with agencies, and it gets a little hairy. So it's good to maintain good relations with different agencies, because it's just a good, best way to operate. So
friends are better than enemies.
Yes. All right.